problem identifying which test to use when, so I figured we would spend today reviewing that. And then probably tomorrow we will get into the second half of series, which is we'll see these tests, we'll see what's going to be on the response for the second part of the series, for the most part. So we're going to kind of go through kind of how you would choose the right test. And you'll notice in addition to your orange sheet, you've got another second green page, how the summary of all the tests. You see that one, you see another one as a flow chart. Okay, so we've got like 3 or 4 different copies of this. Makes most sense to you. Okay. As far as the abbreviations that are on this one, I just noticed this. Don't anticipate using those on the test. The GST, you can't use for geometric series tests. They ask you for it, you can write it down as geometric series tests or alternating series tests. The only thing I would abbreviate would be really MVT and IPT. You saw a discussion of, on the Facebook group I'm on, or POI. Some people call it point of interest, and some people call it point of production. Alright, so let's talk about this funky looking telescoping thing. And again, this is more for your information. I'm not testing on it, I'm not doing homework on it, but I just want you to know, you're going to see the word in the instructions that we're looking at. I wish I would have brought in one of my kids. They got like an old spyglass or telescope that collapses on itself. Okay, but that's kind of the idea behind this is the first term and the last term stay, and then the rest of it kind of collapses in the middle while it cancels out. Okay, so that's why it's called telescoping, because the middle and the end kind of collapses out. So the first thing we're going to do is it wants us to use partial fractions. And find the limit of the series to find the sum of this series. So I'm using partial fraction decomposition here. So I'm looking at this thing right there. And I've got 1 over n times 10 plus 1. And I just want to this week and I end up with positive report. And then eventually it would come down to, so I did plus dot dot dot, right? I put in the n, right? I put in the n value, I would end up with 1 over n. And then this one would end up being, but I'd end up with a negative 1, right? And then I'd end up with a positive 1. Eventually you have n minus 1. I'd put n minus 1 in, right? This one. So you see that pattern happen again, and then finally we plug in the last one that we get 1 over n, the last one. So eventually, everything cancels except for 1, minus 1 over n, plus 1. So you see how we took the telescope and we crunched it down. So the part that you look into and the part that you see on it are the 1 and the 1 over n plus 1. So that was the telescope. Okay. So what they want us to do though is they want us to just find the limit of it. So I'm going to go ahead and put it as n approaches infinity, minus 1 plus 1. So when I put infinity into this denominator, what do I get? 1 over infinity, which is better known as what? 0, so my final answer is. So if I had something that was telescoping like that, I would actually use more approximations. So, like I said, I wanted to do one with you so you saw at least what a telescoping was and understood what it meant. It's probably not going to show it. What happens when I draw something else? So flip to the back page. Alright, so let's talk about strategies for choosing a test, okay? We had 9 before grade. We add that telescoping one in, that's 10, so I still don't really count it as 9. Okay. We have these 9 or 10 series for determining convergence or divergence of an infinite series. And at times, more than one test can be applied. Okay, there's usually one that's the best. But our goal is supposed to be to choose the most efficient test, the one that requires the least amount of work, the most efficient way to get to the design of the convergence. Okay. So I think we started catching on to this a little bit. First thing you want to look for are these 4 things, right? Or really these 3 things. Is it geometric? Which, remember, you're looking for an R value, right? So it's R to the n. So looking for geometric. We're looking for a P series, which, remember, is 1 over n with p, right? So the value of the denominator there. Alternating, what is an alternating? Has to have a negative 1, which is usually in the numerator. Negative 1 to the n usually indicates an alternating. And then the telescoping is the one with the n, okay? So if it's one of those 4 types, use that test, okay? Then you check to see if it can be compared to one of the special. Because if it can be compared, you can easily compare it to a P series or a geometric series specifically. Then you can use a limit comparison or a direct comparison, which is where this gets done. Okay. If that doesn't work, try nth term and see if it approaches 0. Okay. Remember, at that point tells us if it diverges. Okay. So if you get that it diverges, great, you're done. If not, then you've got to go on to either integral ratio or gradient. If there is an exclamation point, or sorry, not an exclamation, a factorial, right? We use ratio. If it is to the nth power, that's where we use root. Otherwise, you probably are going to go with some sort of an integral test. Okay? In tonight's homework, I think that you use, it's a matching thing we can get with. So it's a matching test you're going to use, and then you can use that test. Okay? Alright, so here's what I want you to do. I want you to yourself, without talking to your neighbor, we're going to actually calculate the tests and do practice the tests and we'll see that one more time. But on those problems, A to G, okay, I want you to see if you can figure out which test you're going to use. Okay, just write down the name of the test. It'll take up the entire box for you. Okay? So I'm going to give you about 2 minutes right now to see if you can figure out which test you're going to use. to, and I'm going to compare it to one over n, which may have mentioned some of those so, which is basically a p-series, right? So we know that that's a p-series. What's the p? E is equal to 1. Okay, so on a p-series, when it is equal to 1, it diverges, right? So, the other thing we have to know is if it is... Okay. So I know that my comparison diverges, so I also have to look at my limit comparison. So n diverges infinity. I have to do my original over my comparison. Decide what its limit actually is. So I go ahead and I start plugging, or I start manipulating that, I get 1, or 1 plus 1, and I get 1. So that would be n over 4 n plus 1, which I have to use the limit of the limit. If there were some other weird things that happened, it was like 0 or if it was less than 0. But as long as it was greater than 0, they either both converge or both diverge. So that's now enough to pass that part of the comparison test, but it was definitely divergent. Okay, let's see. Geometric P series alternate. Can it be easily compared to a geometric or P series? Not really. But if you have an N on the top and the bottom, not really. Okay. So what's the next thing that says on the list? Answer is, let's try an N through test. Okay. So remember that one is the limit as N approaches infinity of N. So, what's that equal to? 1/4, right? Either I do L'Hopital or I look at the coefficients. Which does not equal 0. So, on an N through test, as long as it does not equal 0, what does that mean? Remember, an N through test is only good for N through test. Okay? E-series? Okay, E-series has to look like that. Look like that? Or compared to looking like something like that? Not really, right? So if I look, so it's definitely not geometric, it's not P-series, it's not alternate, right? So I have to go to the next one. It definitely can't be compared to any of those because I've got an N on the top and the bottom, that doesn't really work out. So, I could try nth term. The problem with nth term is when I get a 0 over a 0, basically, or 0 over 1. That should equal 0, doesn't it? So that means the nth term test didn't work, right? So I have to pick either integral, ratio, or root. Ratio test typically has what in it? A factorial. Does it have a factorial? A root test is usually something to the nth power, right? Or a square root of something. Does it have that? No. So this one I'd probably look for. So the integral infinite as the limit as B approaches infinity. Actually, before I do that, I'm probably going to rewrite it as negative 1 approaches to x, which is negative x. Thank you. if it's one third, again, you have to look at your chart, okay? Greater than one, less than one. Less than one, something. That's the like ratio of who's the key to that one. Factorial, right? Alright, so for ratio, we do the limit as n approaches infinity, where we have to substitute it. n plus 1 factorial. Yes, plus 1. We're technically supposed to divide, but we just go ahead and multiply by the I'm going to start expanding, so this one gets expanded to n.